President Trump spoke at a meeting of the Heritage Foundation's President's Club on Tuesday in Washington. Tom Brenner, The New York Times, Washington. President Trump has denied a congresswoman's account that he told a grieving soldier's widow in a phone call that the soldier knew what he signed up for, saying on Wednesday that the Democratic representative's description was totally fabricated. Representative Frederica Wilson, Democrat of Florida, recounted details of Mr. Trump's phone call with Sergeant LaDavid T. Johnson's widow. On Tuesday, Ms. Wilson was in the car with the widow, Maisha Johnson, and said she overheard the phone call from the president, who was on speakerphone. Sergeant Johnson, a Green Beret, was killed in an ambush in Niger earlier this month that killed three other soldiers and injured two. Ms. Wilson said that during the call, the president told Ms. Johnson something to the fact that he knew what he was getting into when he signed up, the congresswoman said in an interview on MSNBC's Morning Joe on Wednesday. Representative Frederica Wilson, Democrat of Florida, speaking at a news conference on Capitol Hill in 2014. Mark Wilson at images, but that's not the worst part, Ms. Wilson said. She was crying the whole time and when she hung up the phone she looked at me and said he didn't even remember his name. That's the hurting part. Mr. Trump took to Twitter early Wednesday and disputed the account. Democrat congresswoman totally fabricated what I said to the wife of a soldier who died in action and I have proof. Said Donald J. Trump at Real Donald Trump October 18, 2017. Mr. Trump did not say what proof he had. Sergeant Johnson, 25, was from Miami Gardens, FLA, the Defense Department said. He and Ms. Johnson had two children, and Ms. Johnson is pregnant. Mr. Trump said Monday that he contacted families of fallen American soldiers and said past presidents have not always done so. He singled out former President Barack Obama, saying he had not made such calls, an assertion that quickly drew angry rebukes from former Obama aides.